Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is The World of Wayne, and happy Throttle Thursday. Today we're going to be continuing with the Poker Ducati 1299 Panigale R Final Edition. I said that all in one go, didn't I? Today I don't know if I'm going to need the bike, and I haven't even got a clue how far we're going to get today, but remember I told you that the bike is looking like it's almost complete, but we're not even halfway through? Well, that's because the detail starts now. Today we're going to do the handlebars, and believe me, the amount of detail on here took me half an hour just to dig out all the bits for this. So this is going to be really close-up work. I have focused in all my cameras for that reason, so you can see the amount of detail we're going to be putting on here. We've also got lots of decals to put on, so I'm going to do those today. Don't know if we're going to get past the handlebars today, but there is quite a bit to do. So once again, if you want to get this for yourself, I haven't got a clue where you can get it from at the moment because I don't think it's actually being made anymore. So my advice to you is use your friend Google and see if it's available in your territory. But without further ado, let's get cracking. Okay, so the left handlebar's obviously got the clutch on it, and this is the pin that we're going to start to assemble everything together. Now, it doesn't help you with letting you know which ones to put in first. So I'm guessing this one goes in first here. I'm just going to leave that in there like that. Then we've actually got the grip. That's going in next, and that'll only let you take it so far down. And then on the end of that, we have got this cap. So now this cap is going into the end here. Doesn't say to glue it, but it is quite a tight fit. So I've got that in as much as I can, pushing that back. So now that looks like that. Now in the middle section, we've got these pieces here. Now it's not asking me to glue these. We're going to be screwing these in. So one's going one side, and the other will be going the other side here. Now, you can probably see there's a flat area in the middle there. There's one on this side at that side, but there's a flat area just there. Now, this is going to be sitting over that. So, it wraps around the lip of this one here. So, we've got one side on there, and then the other side is going on top just here like that. Now, this is hard work, isn't it? Okay, this is going to be held in with three screws in here. Now, these are going to be tiny screws. These are end screws, which I've got here. Let's see if my ends, my PHO screwdriver can handle these, which I think they can. Turn it over, and let's get these screws in. So, one in here. Excellent. And then we've just got two just above it there. Now remember, we're going into plastic, so we just want this to be tight enough to hold it. You don't want to over tighten this. Now we've got a couple of details which I've just cut off the sprues there, which are going to go into the little holes that we've got. One let me get this right, one down the bottom here and one just at the top just here as well. So let's get some glue in my tray. Not a lot. Put one of these in the bottom area here. These are like little switches. Put one in just like that there. Now this hopefully will give you an impression of the detail we're going to be putting in today. So on this side, just drop that in. There you go, that's the second little switch in there. And then finally, we've got one big one just to put at the back here. A little bit of glue again into this channel. And that's going on this way. It actually faces towards the grip. So that looks like that there. Now I'm just looking what I can get to, because I have got to put some decals just on this section here and the other side over here. I'm going to do that afterwards. So, put that to one side and bring over this metal handle now. And I've got lots and lots of little details for this. So let me bring these all up. Do you see what I mean? That's a lot of detail, isn't it? Okay, now I don't know what order these are going to go in. So, I'm going to try my best. And I'm starting with this one just here. Now it's going to be this way round, with this pin here facing my left. So the first thing I'm going to put in is this bracket here, which is going to straddle this middle section here, just like that there. Now, the other thing before I actually put this section here onto this section is we need to put a little spring just over that nipple there. Now, I really hope I don't lose this. This is spring SP05. And if you look at this pack here, this is tiny. So there's two springs in this pack, and that's what it looks like there. Because this is so tiny, I am going to get my glasses on so I can start putting this in and hopefully not losing anything. So exactly like you saw before, but this can push onto this nipple without it falling out. So you see, it's on just like that. Okay, let's put this together. That looks kind of good there. I'm happy with that so far. I want to keep this in place, so I'm going to be putting a G screw just through the top there. So I've got that here. I'm going to start that off so it goes through each of the sections. Going to be very tricky, this is. Just like that, and have this go all the way through these parts. And there you go. So they're all held together. And because of the spring on that now, this is going backwards and forwards like that. Excellent. So we've got the first bit done. Now, again, it's trying to figure out what order these go in. So I'm going to take this section just here, and I'm going to put the reservoir, which looks like this, onto the top. It's going to fit on just like that there, and it's held in with a J screw. So as you can see, I'm holding it like that. And we'll get this in here. The good thing about this one is there is a locating lug to help line that up for you. And there you go. That's in place. Got a little cap to put on there, which is J21. That's this cap here. That can just push on top. I don't think we have to glue this one. It should be quite a tight fit. There we go. Got a little reservoir there. Now the middle of this here is going to be going onto the middle section of the handle we just created. And again, we have got a little lug that's going to help us position that in just like this. There. Once again, that's held in with our favorite little J screw. In this hole next to it, I need a little bit of glue. I apologize for not knowing what some of these parts are that I'm putting in. I keep saying that. I rode bikes. I don't really know parts of them. So I'm going to push this one in. There you go. That's what that looks like. Okay, on the bottom of this section here, I've got J49, which looks like this. This is going to have a pipe attached to it eventually, but I've got to put this in just underneath here. It has got a little D-shaped pattern. And I'm pushing that in really hard, so that's all the way in there. Now, on the end of this, I've got to put a little bit of cable. Now, in this kit, we do have two kinds of cables. We've got RG, which is quite thick. What we need is the RF, the thinner one here, and I need 210 mils of that. So, that means 21 of these squares. So 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21. That's over here. And not only that, you've just seen, I know my 3x table. So you know me, what I'm going to do is on that piece I put in, I'm just going to put some glue just around that nipple there. Put the cable on, and that way it's not going to fall off. So I've kept that into place. Perfect. We're then linking this hose. So the underside of this hose is going to go into under the reservoir here, and the other side is going into the hole just inside the bracket. I'll get this in and show you what it looks like. It's a little bit fiddly. So then that looks like that there. So we're going to be adding what we've just created here onto this. Now, as you can see, we have got a little flat section there. So this is going to go into that flat section like that. And it's going to be held in from the other side with this bracket here. And that's going to clamp everything into place. My advice is to just put it in loosely for now, put it in position, and then tighten it up. But the screws that we need to attach this are size O screws. So as you see, I put one in the other side. It's very loose. Just like that, and then position this where it needs to be. So it should be on in that position so that this top section here is parallel with this section here. So I'm going to tighten it up in this position. And I can operate the brake. I think that's brilliant. I like that. And then all we've got to do is we've got to take this section here. And my advice is just put a little bit of oil just on the back of this section just here. Because I need to slide this on. There you go, just like that, line it up, perfect. It's going to be held in with F screws just at the top there. Very long screws these are, but get them all the way in. And then at the bottom of this section, just on a hinge joint here, we've got the bottom. That's just going to go over this section just here. Once again, held in with an F screw. Now, eventually this is going to clip onto the bike, so I want to make sure that I've kept that quite loose. Just for now, just so I don't lose that. But that is the first handle completed. Now, before I continue and do the other one, and I think I'm going to do the other one off camera because it's exactly the same thing, even though it's the throttle one, it has got a different reservoir. I'll show you what that looks like. I actually want to put all of the decals on this so you can see what it looks like with the decals on. And there we go, I've put all the decals on this now. Now, you know what really lets this kit down? Is none of the decals match where they need to go. I mean, it's referring to a WD-20, which doesn't exist. And then it says on the other side, put a WD-21. Well, WD-21 is a left arrow. WD-22 is a right arrow. So I'm guessing the left and right arrows need to go where they need to go. So I've done the decals here on both sides, and that is one finished section here. It's such a letdown because the whole kit is brilliant, but the decals are really what's letting this down. But that is so much detail in one little bit. Let me just show you that on the close-up camera. As you can see, it's just so detailed. But I've got to make another one of these for the throttle side now. I probably will do that off camera because this has taken me 2 hours. 2 hours to do one side of the handlebars. So next time when you see it, we are actually going to be attaching these, as you can see, to the motorcycle. So we'll have these into place. Not much to do after that, we're just adding all the armor pieces. So we are almost coming to the end, but I did want to take my time on this one just so you can see how detailed this is. But we've done a throttle Thursday. Hopefully we'll have another one of these next week. I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.